for our stepping forth ceremony. I'd like to invite the audience to now please rise and join me in the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic which stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. You may be seated. I'd like to start the program by inviting the Honorable First Selectman, Mrs. Vicki Tesoro, up to share some reflections.
Good afternoon, everyone. Nice to see you. I would just like to make one remark, or a couple remarks, before I do my formal comments. This is the first year that I'm able to actually spend the entire ceremony with all of you. I'm usually rushing out of here immediately to rush across town to get to Madison to do to participate in their ceremony as well. But this year, things were changed a little bit, so I get to spend the afternoon with you too. So I'm excited by that. Next, I want to thank the Hillcrest Marching Band for their performance in the Memorial Day Parade. Let's give them a round of applause, if you will. I will tell you, they literally had my back. I was marching in front of them, and thankfully they were in back of me, so they protected me while I was marching. So I just want to say thank you to all of them. So, good afternoon. Congratulations to the Hillcrest Middle School Class of 2023 on your stepping forth. It is a pleasure and an honor to be here today. Thank you to Mr. Rickert, Mrs. Laird, and the Board of Education for your service to our community. And welcome to Dr. Semmel as well. Also, thank you to the PTA and all those who volunteer their time to make our outstanding school system even better. I want to take a moment to thank all the first responders, healthcare professionals, and veterans in our audience. Thank you for your service, and let's give them a round of applause. A very special thank you to the teachers, administrators, and staff at Hillcrest, and throughout our district who work tirelessly every day. To those of you in the audience and to your fellow professionals, let's also give them a big round of applause. To our students, today is a celebration about you. This day symbolizes an end and a beginning. You worked very hard and you succeeded. You are ready for the next step in your education. As you move forward to high school, you can expect to learn many new things, meet new teachers, and make more friends. You will have an amazing array of choices as to activities and classes at Trumbull High or at the high school of your choice. There is something for everyone. Do your very best to work towards your goals while you're enjoying the things high school offers. You have the greatest source of support and guidance in your parents, but also know there are many teachers, administrators, counselors, and many others who are both available and willing to assist you. So on behalf of the town of Trumbull, congratulations to the teachers, administrators, and staff for your efforts in making this day possible. Congratulations to the parents and families, and congratulations to you, the students, on a job well done. Enjoy your special day. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mrs. Tesoro. Now I'd like to introduce our president of the National Junior Honor Society, Ms. Sarah Nadesan, to share some introductions and reflections.
Thank you, Mr. Rickert. Good afternoon, Principal Rickert, Assistant Principal Laird, teachers, parents, guests, and the class of 2023. My name is Sarah Nadesan, and I'm the National Junior Honor Society President. I welcome you all today to look back at our experiences in middle school. Our time at Hillcrest has been highlighted by all the changes that we have experienced. Today, we will look back at the memories we have made together during the last 3 years, which we will carry throughout high school and for the rest of our lives. Let us remember how we have grown, changed, and the lessons that we have learned throughout the years. Lessons that will last a lifetime. When we first entered Hillcrest, we were scared and nervous. We were wondering how we would navigate the hallways, how we would find our classrooms, and how we would make new friends. We wondered if the students and teachers would be friendly. We became to realize that the hallways were manageable and the classes were not that difficult to find. And the students and staff were very friendly and guided us when we needed help. Transitioning from elementary school to middle school was not easy. When we first stepped into the role of being a middle schooler, the world had changed and brought new challenges that carried a lot of uncertainty. COVID brought unforeseen changes to school as we knew it. As we entered sixth grade, COVID was at its peak and we were still wondering if our families and friends were okay. We had to take many precautions, which made it very hard to get into the swing of going back to school. Yet we still did not let that stop us from learning in any way possible. All of the teachers made it very possible for us to learn from home. Learning from home had its advantages and disadvantages. For one, we could learn from the comfort of our own home. We never had to get changed in the morning or worry about what to wear. Pajamas were always an option. Unfortunately, learning from home had its disadvantages as we faced several distractions going on at home. We wanted to see our friends and interact with one another, but due to the hybrid year, this was not possible. Due to the hybrid year, the class sizes were smaller and we could not be with all of our friends. Yet we persevered. We learned more about technology and more about ourselves. We learned how to overcome problems and challenges and rise above them. As the year came to an end, so did our first year at Hillcrest. Summer quickly passed, and we returned to school as seventh graders, stronger from all that we had endured through the previous year's ups and downs. Seventh grade was filled with so many wonderful memories of friends and new friendships blossoming. Our teachers worked tirelessly to help us adjust back to normal post-COVID hybrid year. Seventh grade was when we finally were able to come together as a class, a whole class, and were able to learn face-to-face. Although COVID had soured the transition from elementary school to middle school, it ultimately brought us closer together. Seventh grade was an exciting time. We were able to see our friends. The Halloween dance was a welcome sight as we were able to dress up and dance the night away. It reminded us of how much that we had missed. In the classroom, our imagination soared. In social studies, we created countries and played parts. There are presidents, vice presidents, spies, and advisors. We learned to not take things for granted and the importance of fighting for a peaceful world. As the remaining days of a seventh grade began to end, we celebrated with an annual seventh grade field day. Whether it was kickball, dodgeball, or games, we loved the competition. It was a great way to come together, wrap up the year, and end on a high note. Entering eighth grade, we entered a new phase of middle school. We were the oldest. We were very excited about the year ahead and the field trips, and looking forward to high school. As eighth graders, the workload intensified, but we handled the challenges as they came. The year began with the career project, where we researched a career. We began thinking about our future and what we wanted to be. In science, we created portable and cost-efficient pods to help bring materials to those in need. Our community service project in social studies furthered this goal and taught us how to help others through difficult times. In math, we began thinking about the near future and the excitement of driving a car. We completed the car project where we had to figure out the slope of how long we'd drive and the cost-efficient the trip to Hawaii would be. Which car company had the better deal of getting the cost low as possible for a family trip? The lessons and experiences from middle school taught us to be better students, better friends, and better people. As the eighth grade year came to an end, we were excited to celebrate our accomplishments. We had the Holiday Hill trip where we got to have fun with our friends and run around doing different types of activities. We enjoyed the unlimited food and the fun times with our friends. The last official activity as eighth graders was the eighth grade formal. It was an amazing night where we danced the night away, met new friends from Madison, and celebrated our accomplishments with our friends. To end our years, we had many great memories. Every grade had taught us the importance of stepping into a different perspective and experiencing new things we had yet to explore. Sixth grade taught us to persevere and keep on going even through difficulties. Seventh grade taught us to instill peace in our world. And lastly, eighth grade taught us to take care of our community and our world. Middle school has taught us to become better people even when we step into a new chapter of our lives. I'm honored to stand here today and be a part of this graduating class. Thank you to all the teachers and parents for making this possible and pushing us to reach our full potential. I hope you all remember to keep making new memories, experiences, and never stop stepping forward. Today, as we step forth, let us remember all of our hard work and become a better version of ourselves. Thank you.
Thank you, Sarah, to our esteemed and beloved 8th grade class. On behalf of your teachers, Mrs. Laird, Dr. Semmel, the Trumbull Board of Education, First Selectwoman DeSoro, I want to congratulate you on making it through your middle school years. When we met just a short 3 years ago, I promised you that middle school would fly by, and indeed it has. About a month ago, I was attending a kindergarten orientation for my middle child, and some comments made by the superintendent at the time really left an impact on me when I think about the stepping forth ceremony today. He shared that the most important thing we can do for our students is to make sure they stay curious and remain in awe of the world around them. If we can do that, we are inspiring lifelong learners. We can't ask for much more than that. You are more than prepared for life in high school. You will continue to grow and succeed. When you stumble and experience failure, you all will at some point. Please remember that overcoming that adversity is what will always separate you from those whom you are competing against. Life in high school and beyond is not unlike a hard multiple choice test. Sometimes the answer is all of the above, sometimes it's none of the above. The tough part is figuring out which is the right answer. We celebrate you today, but remember to say thank you to everybody around you. Thank you to your parents for knowing that this is the right time to have those tough conversations with you and hold the line, so that they don't have to do it when you're older. Say thank you to your teachers for believing in you and pushing you so you continue to grow. And last but not least, thank yous to the friends that you have made in school. Thank you to your friends that have been there since preschool, and thank you to the friends that you've just made in the last few weeks or months. Just remember, they need you just as much as you need them. Now, if you're to ask any one of the educators up on stage or in the audience about whether or not classes or grades take on identities, they would all agree, saying, yes, they do. As a teacher, when I was a social studies teacher, when I had classes that were after lunch, I remember those classes were all either completely off the wall or everybody was in a food coma and there's absolutely no in between. And as a principal, I find this concept to be true as well. For the rest of my life and career, there's only one word that will come to mind when I think of this 8th grade class: resilient. You came to this school with the odds stacked against you. You did not take a tour of the building as 5th graders. Your counselor, Mr. Rago, was not able to visit your elementary school. Your families were not able to meet me and the assistant principal at the time in an uncomfortably warm cafeteria in the spring to learn about what middle school is all about. Your first year, for most of the year, you only saw you 2 days a week. You could not see your smiling faces until more than halfway through 7th grade. Despite all that, as I shared with you face-to-face just a few weeks ago, you are leaving Hillcrest with as strong and as positive a reputation as any class I have ever had in my years as an educator. Your resilience to not only overcome these challenges, but to rise to every occasion is remarkable and inspiring. You were the leaders of a school that had a girls' championship basketball team. You helped earn 2 esports national championships. Your work in our SAVE Club earned national recognition last week. You participated in service projects that supported the homeless, provided gifts for hospitalized children, made care packages for nurses, and even provided coaching for some of our younger members of the Trumbull community. You raised money for breast cancer research, the Make-A-Wish Foundation. You made care packages for the Bridgeport Rescue Mission, blankets for the Binky Patrol, and wrote inspirational messages all around campus. The cherry on top is that you're also amazing students, earning academic distinctions, such as 3 straight years being honored by the Governor's Reading Challenge and making Hillcrest rank 6th in all middle schools in the state of Connecticut based on Next Generation Accountability. You are well-rounded, you are leaders, and you are role models. Most important, you're Hawks. And we're forever proud of you and grateful for what you've done for our school. In closing, I'd like to leave you with a thought and a challenge as you move forward in your lives. Too often, we mistake work ethic and hard work for luck. To do so is a mistake. The work ethic you develop right now will set you apart for the rest of your life. During the 2007-2008 season, on their way to winning a Super Bowl, Coach Coughlin of the New York Giants would frequently quote a Roman philosopher to his team, saying, "Luck is when preparation meets opportunity." Even our fan favorite Ted Lasso once said, "The harder you work, the luckier you get." Of all the things that are out of your control, don't let your work ethic get in the way of accomplishing your goals. We're grateful to share this moment with you and your families. Don't forget, once a Hawk, always a Hawk. Stay in touch as we can't wait to see all the wonderful things you do in your lives. We are so proud of all the things that you're about to accomplish.